Joining us now live on the scene in Boston, Massachusetts, ABC News reporter Sushana Walsh. Sushana, thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Hi, Larry. Thanks for having me on.
Well, you just heard Brian Wilson give the overview of everything. First of all, what else has developed that we have missed? And more importantly, I know they haven't officially named these suspects, but
correct.
I know how things work when you're talking amongst reporters and off the record. Is there a suggestion that they know who these guys are and they just haven't released the names yet?
Well, you know, the identification, I think we're not going to be close to getting that anytime soon, especially because, as you know, Suspect 2 is still on the loose. Suspect 1 is dead. He was brought into the hospital early this morning. As he was going in, he was already suffering from cardiac arrest around 1:20 this morning, 1:35 he was dead. And, you know, Brian mentioned this briefly, but what was interesting is in the press conference just a few minutes ago is the doctor said, you know, he had some gunshot wounds, but he also had wounds that were, that showed that there was something besides gunshots. And, you know, I know you mentioned that there could have been some sort of explosive device, and the doctor was asked that specifically, and he said he wasn't sure yet, but it's a possibility.
Mm. And so the suggestion is that perhaps this suspect, as well as the other suspect who's still at large, could potentially be strapped with explosives and interested in some sort of suicide bombing situation if necessary.
The police have characterized both suspects now. One is deceased, but the suspect that's still on the list as armed and very dangerous and resident in the area and really over that region should be very careful. As you said, that there's not going to be public transportation. Schools, even businesses in the area are being asked to shut down because it is a dangerous situation.
Can you give me, where are you right now, Sushana?
I'm in Boston. I'm actually right by where the incident took place on Monday, right by the finish line.
Yeah, the situation, of course, now is twofold. Number one, of course, they want to get the suspects because the suspects were involved in the bombing, and there's an interest in getting those people under control and arrested. But I guess the greater concern right now is for public safety.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, it's twofold. They need to get this guy, suspect number two, because he is a danger to the region and to the area. And also, they want to keep the residents in Watertown safe and make sure that this guy doesn't get any further away. So, you know, especially when you're dealing with somebody who has perpetrated such an attack like this, who has access to other weapons, they have to keep the community safe.
Sushana Walsh, ABC News reporter in Boston, is our guest. And Sushana, can you just give our listeners an idea of the neighborhood of Watertown? What is the proximity to Boston? Where is it geographically to Boston? And what kind of neighborhood is it?
It's close. You know, it's a suburb of Boston. What was interesting is listening to one of the doctors who actually operated on the man who was brought in and is now deceased that we don't know his identification except suspect number one. He actually lived in Watertown, and he said that he heard the explosions, he heard the gunshots, and he himself took it upon himself to go into the ER. He raced there and got there just moments before.
Oh, wow. And then he ended up being the doctor who treated
yes,
the suspect.
Exactly.
Wow, that's amazing.
And he was asked. It is an unbelievable story. And you know, he said he called the ER. He told them what was going on. Then he got into his car and went there. And he was asked, how did you feel about operating on somebody who could have possibly perpetrated these attacks? And he said that you treat every patient the same way. Obviously, you know, he ended up dying shortly after getting to the hospital, but it's still an incredible tale.
Wow. And go ahead, Brian.
No, so as there's sort of common imagine that the streets are not as busy as they normally would be right now because people are basically just staying home and the transit systems are not operating.
Right. Well, it's still early here, but also, you know, I think that people are still going to be going about their day. A lot of people are glued to the news, but a lot of people are just going to be walking out trying to get into public transportation, and that's when they're going to find out then. And, you know, I do think that the community is really glued to all the news right now, but there's going to be a lot of people that are very frustrated not being able to get to work, but really the police are just trying to keep not just Watertown, not just Boston, but the entire region safe because this guy is still on the loose.
Sushana Walsh in Boston, ABC News reporter, thank you so much for joining
us.
And as the day develops, we will try to check back in with you as news